So breast cancer is the number one in two women, and most of those women will receive some radiation treatment as part of their therapeutic sequence. A lot of women come to us and ask, what's going to be the amount of radiation that go in other part of my body? They are very concerned of being exposed to radiation. And this is a study that we did. The study has evaluated five different techniques of breast radiation, some old one and some new one. So one of the goals of the study was obviously to get some numbers, and we calculated this number for a very typical woman. We had a patient coming here that has had a CT scanner that we use for planning, and we use those images and use into the Monte Carlo. The purpose of the study is to relieve this number, and so patient can now have a rationale to discuss with their doctors. They can ask to their doctors, what my technique going to give me in terms of risk, in terms of the overall body exposure to radiation. In the past, we used to deliver a fair amount of dose to other organ, but with breast IMRT, we reduce this amount by a factor 5. Yeah, we used to use a piece of metal on the shape of a wedge, and so the radiation that go through here will be deposited into the breast, while the radiation that go here will be scattered. And it happened that some of those scatter will reach some other part of the body, increasing the amount of dose that is distributed. Today with breast IMRT, instead of this piece of wedge, we are just shaping the beam as long as it's delivered. And in doing so, we prevent this scatter, and we are dramatically reducing the amount of dose that go to other part of the body. We also found that a technique developed at Sunnybrook that involves the implantation of tiny radioactive seed into the breast is even safer. On the other hand, we found that a technique that is also currently widely used that involves the implantation of a balloon or catheter into the breast and that use TET treatment of the 5-day is giving a little bit higher dose to the total body. So what does that mean for women? Today, women are diagnosed at an early stage. If you look at the data published in the United States, 60% of the women are diagnosed at an early stage. And 98% of those women will be alive at 5 years. So if anything, we're not allowed to harm those patients. We have to be very prudent and avoid creating secondary cancer.